Hey guys, TJ here, and today we're going to be talking about Atypical Season 1. This is kind of like if Abed from Community had his own show on Netflix, except instead of him being obsessed with popular culture, he's obsessed with Antarctica and all of its wildlife. Atypical is a Netflix original comedy series. It has 8 episodes in the first season. The show's about Sam, an 18-year-old high school senior. He happens to be on the autism spectrum. He's high-functioning, but he still has a lot of trouble trying to figure out how to interact in a social circle. After a conversation with his therapist, he comes to the conclusion that he's ready to get out there and try dating, something that he has never really done in the past, and that he's kind of intimidated by because he does have such a hard time understanding some of the social cues that come along with dating, especially in your teenage years. So this show really revolves around the question of what it means to be normal, and if you are different in some sort of way, does that really exclude you from the life that everyone else has? The show really highlights the struggles that people with autism have to go through in order to navigate through the social cues that are in society, things that you don't necessarily always know when you have autism. And it's nice to see that they took this with comedy because it could have been very easy to just turn this into a drama in which you always feel bad for Sam because it's so hard for him to navigate through the world of high school and dating. I would say the majority of the cast does a really great job in just highlighting the struggles that come with one either being autistic or having to, in a way, change the way that you live your life because you're helping someone in your family who does have autism. The actor who plays Sam does the best job in this entire show. Everyone else does a very good job in supporting him, but really he is the star of the show, hands down. In the case of Sam's sister, she's always been very overprotective. In a certain way, she's kind of built like the shell around her because she always has to be looking out for Sam instead of trying to focus on who she is. The mom in the show, played by Jennifer Jason Leigh, she also has this problem because she has lived her whole life being this protector of Sam, but now that he's trying on his own to go out into the world and kind of experience things from a different way, a different perspective, trying to really join society in a way. Well, she doesn't really know how to deal with that because all of her life she's been this protector and she's had this really one role that she's been locked into. And so now that, you know, she's finding that she has a lot more free time and doesn't have to worry about Sam all the time now, she's trying to think, you know, has she lived the life that she wanted to live all this time? And she has this side plot that goes throughout the season that I don't necessarily think was handled that well. It kind of felt out of place. It might have been like an element from the show before it was completely formed that kind of just stood in the show. But it wasn't the focus of the show, so it really wasn't that big of a deal. The way in which they handle Sam's kind of humor is almost as if he doesn't react in the way that you'd expect. He does have a hard time trying to figure out how to react to certain situations, while other people obviously think that it just comes with human nature. But for Sam, it's not so easy to tell what other people are thinking or what other people are feeling. But when he does know what they're feeling, he obviously feel those things. It's just a hard time for him to express it. This season is really about Sam undergoing a mission to try to get a girlfriend, and it's not necessarily the easiest thing, especially for someone on the autism spectrum that has a hard time reading social cues. It's almost as if it's like a research project for him. He's trying to go and find the right way to become this person that will be able to date and function normally in society. The humor in the show really comes from the fact that Sam doesn't necessarily understand some of the things that we do and we take as normal. And so when the audience looks at it, we can actually see that what we think is normal in social occasions doesn't necessarily always really make sense. In a way, he's almost seeing things more clearly than the people around him, and that is really funny. And also, a lot of the advice in this show gets misinterpreted by Sam, and when the advice gets misinterpreted, obviously comedy ensues. This makes the idea of autism and living with autism a little bit more understandable because in a way it kind of, you know, points out the ways in which we are different but are also the same. The tone of the show isn't necessarily the most consistent. Sometimes it just goes for complete lighthearted comedy, then they kind of throw elements of drama in there that don't always work well, or at the very least they're not always incorporated in the most smooth of ways. These are only 8 episodes at 30 minutes each, so it's a pretty quick watch if you wanted to get through the series, and it's fairly enjoyable to watch just in your spare time. Having a comedy show about autism could be considered a kind of a controversial topic, but I really think that the series did a pretty good job in kind of just humanizing the perspectives that people have when either they live with it or when someone they love is autistic. I think if anything, humor is the best medicine for kind of trying to deal with any sort of hardship or struggle, or maybe just a difference. This isn't the funniest show of all time, And it definitely is not the most consistent in terms of tone. At certain times in the show, it goes for a hyper-realist perspective. Sometimes we're placed inside of Sam's head when he's being, you know, confronted by a bunch of sensory objects and he's having kind of like a meltdown. But other times, like, ridiculous little things happen, like people act in ways that they would never act in real life. And I was trying to figure out where the real heart of this series lies. I feel like they could address that in season two, which this show is currently getting. Now, I wouldn't say that this is a go binge, just because this isn't necessarily 100% gonna gel with everyone's taste and humor. Definitely give it a chance. It's not that many episodes, so I'd probably say wait until you have some free time and maybe check the show out. Well, that's all I got today, guys. I hope you liked the video. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.